So I'm sure that a lot of you have already seen the emails, you've gotten the voicemails. You're well aware of the fact that student loan repayments will resume on February 1st of 2022. Now, they don't have to resume. Biden can put them on pause a little bit longer since we are literally still going through a pandemic. Or he could just cancel them altogether, which would be preferable. But his administration has been very clear. They're not going to do that. Student loan repayments will resume February 1st, 2022, like it or not. So as Zach Friedman of Forbes explains, White House Press Secretary Jen Psaki confirmed to reporters during a press briefing that the Biden administration won't extend student loan relief and the student loan payment pause will end January 31st, 2022. No, Biden won't extend student loan relief again. Here are some highlights from her comments. In the coming weeks, we will release more details about our plans. We will engage directly with federal student loan borrowers to ensure they have the resources they need and are in the appropriate repayment plan. We are still assessing the impact of the Omicron variant. A smooth transition back into repayment is a high priority for the administration. The Department of Education is already communicating with borrowers to help them to help to prepare for return to repayment on February 1st. Yeah, we know. We've gotten the emails and the voicemails. So helpful. It doesn't really make me feel as if they're trying to help me. I just get a sense of dread when I see I see that I was called and I see the email. It's just, it's so stressful. And I've got to give credit to progressive lawmakers who have been very vocal about this. They're not just calling on Biden to do the bare minimum. Like he promised 10,000 in cancellation, but he won't even do that. But they're calling on him to cancel all of it because student loans are a catch-22. It's a scam. And Jamal Bowman, in a speech that he made on the House floor recently, broke it down in a brilliant way.
Student debt is a national crisis. It was a crisis before the COVID-19 pandemic, and it is an even bigger one now. I can't think of a better opportunity to cancel student loan debt. Today, over 40 million borrowers owe a combined $1.8 trillion in loans, and the share of people who are able to make payments high enough to reduce their principal balance has been rapidly declining. That means for years, people have been doing all they can to make monthly payments, but can only afford to keep up with the interest that accrues. So if someone took out a $30,000 loan to go to a public state university, but can only afford the minimum monthly payments to cover interest, they can be paying hundreds of dollars every month for years without seeing the total amount they owe go down at all. In fact, many borrowers see their debt increase because they can't even keep up with the interest.
And he's absolutely correct. It's a catch-22. It's a scam. And honestly, it's a joke. This is a debt that people just, they will never overcome. They will have this for the rest of their lives. Can't file bankruptcy to get rid of it. You can't do anything. It's truly just, it's ridiculous. And to kind of demonstrate Jamal Bowman's point about how you can never get rid of this, well, I want to share a tweet from Michael Sonato, friend of the show. He shared how much payments he's made towards his student loans, and look at where he's at now. So he originally borrowed about $73,000. He's already paid back a total of $96,000, but yet his remaining balance is $168,000. He's been making the payments consistently, and now he owes double. I mean, with the interest rates, some people are never going to keep up. They'll keep making these incredibly high payments, even if you cap them, whatever the administration is going to do, but it continues to grow. This just has to be canceled. Again, it is so unfair that previous generations were able to go to college and pay it off and afford it. But this generation and Gen Zers, if they want to go to college, which they need to do if they want to find a good paying job, we're told, they're fucked. I mean, you can't get rid of this debt. Now, I want to point you to a tweet made by Qasem Rashid in 2020. It was a great point. So he says, canceling $1.7 trillion in taxes for 600 billionaires, but not $1.7 trillion in student debt for the 45 million Americans is the modern version of let them eat cake. That's exactly it. And even the husband of the transportation secretary has student loan debt. Chasten Buttigieg shared this image, and he says, LOL, no thank you, Merry Christmas, next. And, you know, I responded to this, and I'm like, motherfucker, your husband is the transportation secretary. So, like, I think you're going to be fine. You'll probably be able to pay these off. But why don't you tell your husband to talk to Joe Biden and convince him to cancel student debt? I mean, if you have that opportunity, if you're that close to power, maybe put in some of an effort, not just like joke about it on Instagram. I don't know. I don't get it. The ACLU is also calling on the cancellation of student debt, saying during his campaign, President Biden promised voters broad student loan forgiveness. As president, he hasn't delivered. Student debt cancellation would help close the racial wealth gap while addressing the student debt crisis for millions. Biden must cancel student debt now. Yeah, he must cancel student debt now. Imagine what would happen if he cancels student debt. Currently, we see Democrats sounding the alarms about a sinking approval rating. If he cancels student debt, can you imagine how popular he would be? Can you imagine how many more young people would come out and vote for him? Come out and vote for Democrats in 2022? It's such a missed opportunity. Like, the federal government holds the overwhelming majority of student debt. So he can wipe it away all like that with the stroke of a pen, but he's choosing to not do that because he's a prick. So, I mean, look, it's going to resume. I am not hopeful. Maybe, you know, something will change and he'll choose to postpone it at least, but I'm not holding my breath on cancellation. I just think that a lot of this generation is going to be stuck with student debt for the rest of our lives. So when we're older, we'll still have our student debt and we'll be dealing with the climate apocalypse. Very, very, very hopeful situation to be in.
Come on, man.